Yesterday, I came across a website that said, "Would you like to make money with Twitter?" "Maybe," I replied. The website was talking about a third-party advertising service called Magpie. So I took a look. The way Magpie works is that after signing up, every few tweets that you tweet, after every few tweets that you send out, they let you send out an advertising tweet. Now, they say that the advertising tweet is completely up to you, and you get to choose what you will and will not want to post. They try to help you out by telling you to advertise things that you think that your followers will be interested in. They even have a tool on the website where you can type in your Twitter name, and it will tell you how much you could possibly make per month. So I took a look around the site. I signed up just so I could see everything that the site had to offer, just to make sure what it was, I guess. And I have to be honest, Magpie, what I found really wasn't that great. I mean, there's a setting where after every 5 tweets, it will send out an advertising link. That's a lot of advertising. I don't think I could stay followed to somebody who advertises that much. Like, I could understand a couple times a week, but I don't follow people for their advertisements. Social media is not about having ads shoved in your face when you don't want them. The redundancy for Magpie is really right there with how it's set up. The service pays by follower count, so the self-defeating fact is simple. Use Magpie, get unfollowed, lose all your followers, stop using the service, rebuild your Twitter network, repeat. See why I said redundancy? I mean, it's not technically redundant, but wow. Now, I know a lot of pro-Magpie users are going to say, well, there's no difference between Magpie and putting ads on your blog, which, Travis, you do that. I'll admit I put ads on my blog, but ads on a blog are passive. Twitter, Magpie, advertisement things are just right there in your face. Personally, I think things like Magpie kind of sully the stream and make it a lot less organic than an actual conversation. I'm a blogger with ads in the sidebar, but I don't use Twitter to spam my followers. Social media websites like Twitter are about sharing interesting ideas with other people who find those ideas interesting, not about soapboxing things or trying to make a quick buck. Magpie and other third-party advertisers don't understand this, and they attempt, on some level, to do justice to spamming. Now, I don't have a problem with people who want to monetize their Twitter accounts. I don't have a problem if you want to sell ad space to make some money. My problem is that if Magpie alternates one ad with every 5 tweets and I follow 5 people with Magpie, how many ads am I going to get spammed with? I mean, in theory, the idea is pretty smart, but it needs a lot of work. So here's my question to you. Should Twitter block third-party advertisers and maybe attempt to do something like this themselves, helping people monetize their Twitter accounts in a less spamtastic way? Or should Twitter just say, not our problem, and let Magpie run wild? Here's what I think should happen, if it's possible to happen. I think Twitter should have account settings where if somebody spams you with a certain thing, you can block all advertisements from that certain program website thing. You'd still get all the normal tweets from that one person, but all those ads that they send out will be blocked when you're logged into your Twitter name. But really, I'm just dumbfounded on why somebody would want to monetize the conversation. After all, isn't that really what it is? Follow me and I promise I'll never spam you with a third-party advertiser. And yes, No Shave November, it's going pretty well. I know it's not as epic as CKXCore's beard, but I'm blonde, lay off. I was gonna make a video about my beard and call it heroin beard, but that's really not the type of viewership that I'm aiming for. Let's see, I have 12 days, and then I can shave, and then start filming my new parody video. Slytherins, if you still haven't sent me a picture to whattravissays2@gmail.com of you all decked out in Slytherin / greenish gear, and you wanna be in the Harry Potter parody song, do that now, because I will start getting in contact with you guys sometime next week. Harry Potter midnight showing? Huh? 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 I love how it says 0 a.m. To the TARDIS! Jump cut, jump cut, jump cut, jump cut!